What's more of a wrestler's one? All the way up, right?
All the way up is
okay. I know all the way up. All right. Let's put it live now. So don't say anything yet. Just so we can get some viewers.
It's a top 25 showdown at the campus of UNC Pembroke. 17th ranked Limestone College making the trip up north to Pembroke to take on the 21st ranked UNCP Braves in a highly anticipated Tuesday night match and a dual meet finally at home for the Braves. Good evening and thanks for joining us. Welcome into Lumbee Guaranty Bank Court. John Gross alongside UNCP redshirt senior wrestler Joe Ballantyne. And Joe, this is just the most recent in a stretch of very challenging matchups for the Braves to start off this season.
The Braves, we usually start off a little slow, but we always finish strong where it matters in March, which is always a good thing. So
now, this is a Limestone program that UNCP very familiar with. This is the 15th straight year that UNCP will take on Limestone, and we talked a little bit about before, this is becoming quite the rivalry.
Yeah, a little bit. We're not a big fan of Limestone. They are one of our big rivals. You go away to, like you said in the beginning, it's usually who's home, who's winning the match. Every time we go to Limestone, their stadium, they have a big crowd yelling at us, making fun of us. So we don't like that disrespect. So we try to win that home matches when we verse them here. So
right, yeah, UNCP 5-1 all time at home against Limestone. On the road, they're the opposite, the inverse, 1-5. So really the home team has dominated this series, and we expect to have some really good individual bouts today.
Yes.
What are some weight classes that you're looking out for?
125, Nick Daggett, a true All-American as a freshman, versus James Sass. That's going to be a big match. And then also Sammy Petrikos at 149. He's wrestling a returning national qualifier. Sammy Petrikos was a starter a couple times in a couple matches last year, but he's a true starter in our lineup this year, and it's going to be a huge matchup in this outcome of this match today.
Should be a really exciting night for some wrestling. We'll start things off at 7 p.m. with that highly anticipated 125 bout. So don't go anywhere. We will be back in just a few with the national anthem and starting lineup introductions live from the campus of UNC Pembroke. This is Braves Wrestling on the UNCP Sports Network.
The town of Pembroke, incorporated in 1895, is a proud community rich in heritage. Pembroke is a quaint but growing town, regarded as the social, political, cultural, and commercial center for the Lumbee tribe. the largest American Indian tribe east of the Mississippi River with over 58,000 members. The town hosts a variety of events during the year, none larger than Lumbee Homecoming, which annually brings in over 30,000 visitors. We welcome you to visit our unique town and encourage you to read and learn more about Pembroke.
Choose to transform.
Choose to discover.
Choose value.
Choose to make a difference.
Choose to succeed.
Choose to be a brave.
When you choose UNC Pembroke, you choose small classes and personal attention. You choose quality and affordability because we are an NC Promise campus. Tuition is only $500 a semester in-state and $2,500 a semester out-of-state. Visit uncp.edu or call 910-521-6262 for more information.
A nurse at Scotland Health is
a healer, touching patients' lives at every turn.
An ally, working as a trusted teammate with the best doctors. A blower of bubbles, part child whisperer, part kid at heart.
A winner, recognizing excellence through Daisy Awards.
And of course, a caring friend. Scotland Health nurses are many things to many people. But to us, they're simply better by far.
When a hospital invests in technology, skilled hands and keen eyes have new tools for diagnosing disease and making people better. At Scotland, we were the first in the region to provide 3D mammograms and robotic joint surgery, and the only hospital in
Prince. At 184 pounds, there is currently no entry
And we welcome you back into the English E. Jones Center. We'll get things started with the highly anticipated 125 bout for UNCP, Nick Daggett, a guy who's been a national qualifier twice, and he's taking on James Sass, who's right now ranked second in the region for that weight class. These are two wrestlers who have faced each other three times in the past. Daggett has the series edge 2-1. How much of an advantage does that give you when you're familiar with your opponent like that?
Definitely a lot of confidence going in. Going in, losing to a guy twice messes with your head a little bit. But definitely the advantage on Nick Daggett's part, knowing what he likes and what he likes to do and what he has to do to win that match.
Again, John Gross alongside UNCP redshirt senior wrestler Joe Ballantyne. It's the 21st ranked UNC Pembroke Braves entering today with a 1-3 record, but an absolute gauntlet of a schedule to start off this season. Taking on the 1-0 Limestone Saints, ranked number 17 in the nation. The 15th straight year that these two programs are squaring off against one another. UNCP leads the all-time series 8-6. And as we touched on in the open, the home team has been dominant. UNCP 5-1 at home. They are 1-5 away. So we'll start things off with an exhibition here before we get tonight's dual meet underway.
Looks like a 141 matchup right here. Ethan Nasco from Braves. A lot of hand fighting before they went out of bounds. Limestone is a big first period wrestler. They're going to be coming at you hard. Nasco in a shot and a single leg, trying to bring that up to his feet as they run out of bounds.
Your current matchup at 141 pounds for the Saints. James Benjamin, exhibition matchup for your Braves, Ethan Nasco.
Yeah, Ethan. Redshirt sophomore out of Winston-Salem.
A lot of hand fighting, trying to get familiar from your opponent, trying to see what they like. Hand fighting into a shot as Nasco's in this another single again. Tries a knee slide to a better position. So Limestone is grabbing his leg. Getting caught in a little scramble here. Looks like it might end with a stalemate. Nasco trying to pop his head out, secure the two as he does.
First takedown.
Gets a cradle. He could end the match right here. Has this cradle tight, locked up nice and tight.
4-point near fall there.
And a pin. A nice win for Ethan Nasco to set the tone for the Braves.
In those exhibition matchups, if you're a coach, what are you looking for out of your guys? Might not count on the scoreboard, but I'm sure you still want to see your guy go out there and perform well.
Definitely. It's a good way to just get matches underneath your belt. And like I said before, also a good set tone setter. That's huge for the Braves to set the tone there. Let's start getting a rally off.
So here we go, 125. It's Nick Daggett for UNCP in the gray singlet with the Braves logo on his side. A two-time national qualifier, an All-American as a freshman, finished eighth nationally. This is the fourth all-time meeting between Daggett and James Sass.
Nick Daggett already in a shot. I'm sorry.
Early takedown.
Daggett's pace is very quick and hard. He likes to start going, taking shots real early, trying to get his opponent real tired because his gas tank is very, very big. Like you were saying before, Nick Daggett was a true freshman All-American. Was going to redshirt this year, decided not to. To continue his career here. Escape for Sass.
Just about a minute in. Daggett, an early edge. Taking on James Sass, second of the region at 125.
Daggett in another shot. Trying to pop his head out to score two, and he does. Score now 4-1. Daggett here trying to secure as much time on top as possible to get all those seconds for riding time. At the end of the match, if you get about a minute of riding time, it adds 1 point to the end of the score.
He's up to 53 seconds and counting. And a 4 point near fall for Daggett, who's starting to run away with things.
Yeah, he hit a beautiful tilt. Looks like he's trying to hit it again as he chops down the wrist. Sass is doing a good job of keeping his hips down. But Nick tries to take him the other way.
Stalling warning issued. 45 seconds to go here in the first. Daggett, a comfortable lead. He's on the edge of bonus points territory for the Braves. An escape from Sass finally gets him back on the scoreboard.
Daggett does a nice job of throwing in those fakes right before he shoots. It's a nice setup to keep your opponent on your toes.
Eight seconds to go here in the first. Comfortable edge for Daggett. And a couple takedowns, 4 point near fall there. What'd you like from Nick Daggett?
Definitely a great first period. Get his opponent tired, get him a little scared, especially fighting off your back. It takes a lot of energy. So getting your opponent a little winded for the next two periods is a great start for Nick right here.
So we'll get the second period started again. Two takedowns. 4 point tech fall there for Daggett.
Looks like they're trying to figure out the score here. Nick's choice, he decides to defer. Sass chooses neutral. Daggett in another low single, but Sass does a great job keeping his hips down and away. Sass in a high crotch. Laying on the mat. Daggett's doing a great job of keeping his hips down, putting a lot of pressure on his shoulder. Looks like they're going to end up in a stalemate. A minute and 22 seconds left in the second period.
So they'll bring it back to neutral. Yeah, just over a minute to go here in the second period.
dash, trying to get behind, but Daggett's too quick.
And fourth meeting between these two highly skilled wrestlers at 125, very familiar with each other.
It's always a fun matchup to watch. Another stall call on Sass, giving Nick Daggett a point.
And the second stall of this bout.
Sass in a shot. Daggett keeps his, squares his hips, keeps his hips away. Sass got fingertips on that leg. Might end in another stalemate.
8 seconds remaining in the second period. They get back to neutral. A late shot from Daggett, but it's after the whistle.
A beautiful double, just a tad too late. Daggett chooses bottom. Trying to finish this match with some bonus points. Trying to finish with the major. He's up by 7. Does not have that riding time locked yet.
There's the escape. So up by 8 now. If he can hold it right here, that's major decision for Nick Daggett. Right out of the gates to give UNCP some early momentum.
Sash in another shot. We got a nice little scramble here. Nick gets around for the 2.
Minute 15 to go here in the third.
Riding time is counting with the minute and 57 and counting. Riding time is locked. So that means Nick Daggett will be gaining 1 point after the match.
will reset things.
You got a caution on Sass. Kind of like a full start in football. Went before the whistle. Daggett likes to keep scoring points. He doesn't like to hold off. As he gets in another shot, peeks his head out for the 2.
35 seconds.
It looks like Daggett's trying to get a tech here. He needs to score at least 5 more points. And another shot.
Down to 20 seconds. In his third period, Daggett comfortably in front, looking for some more bonus points for his team. Now within 5, and that'll do it. Nick Daggett, 14-4 is the score. And he moves to 3-1 against Sass in now their fourth meeting all time. And right out of the gates, 4 points for UNCP.
Definitely a great start for the Braves. Keep the momentum going. Jaquan McIntyre at 133.
Majid Corbett and Jaquan McIntyre.
These guys used to wrestle against each other at 125, the weight class below, and they both bumped up to 133.
Corbett, top-ranked wrestler at 133 in the region.
He because you guys wrestling at the edge of the out of bounds. Even if you have a shoelace in bounds, you are still in.
Looks like that shoelace just went a little too far out.
This year there's a new rule that you do not need to wear a hairnet either. Huh. So McIntyre is letting it all hang loose this time. Oh, McIntyre in a nice single. He snatched that right through. He's trying to take that leg out. Corbett, a long guy, it's hard to take that leg out. The little pocket.
Very long. That's long reach for McIntyre. Midway through this first period.
Call it a stalemate.
McIntyre coming off of a 7-4 decision against West Liberty over the weekend. Looking to keep things going to the right direction for the Braves. Got bonus points from Nick Daggett early on. Approaching 1 minute remaining in the first period.
First period tends to be just a lot of hand fighting. Trying to get familiarized with your opponent. But these two, they've seen each other, so they know exactly what they're about to do. Who's going to pull the trigger first?
35 seconds. Spoke to Jaquan earlier. He said he expected a dogfight today, and that's what we've had here in the 133 bout.
Corbett just got hit with stalling. Jay looks like he's been taking most shots.
Ten seconds. Clock ticking away here. Not much going in this first period. 2.6 seconds. We'll bring it back to neutral. And that'll do it for the first period. So two guys really neck and neck there. Neither wrestler able to get anything going in terms of points.
Definitely was still trying to fill each other out on that one.
There's an escape. First point of the bout.
3 seconds or riding time. Riding time tends to be important in all matchups. That 1 point can make a huge difference. Corbett tried to slide by that shot. Trey tried to take a shot. Corbett did a nice job of getting behind. They go out of bounds. Corbin throwing a tight claw in on McIntyre. McIntyre on his feet, trying to get his hips out. As he does, he succeeds on his 1 point escape. Only down by two, he's still definitely in this match.
Minute to go in the second.
Corbett
133 weight class. You mentioned the height of Corbett. How much of an advantage does that give him?
Definitely a lot. Keeping those legs and hips away and having that strength of being able to crowd someone, it's very tough. I do not like wrestling long, tall, and lanky guys. I'll tell you that. People can describe me as one, too.
20 seconds in the second period. Another takedown. 5-1 the score here in favor of Corbett. The Saints look to bounce back here in the second weight class of the evening.
Jay trying to finish on his feet at the end of the period here. Looks like they have finished on bottom.
All right, so you're McIntyre heading into this third period, down by four. What's the mindset? What are you looking to do?
Great choice by McIntyre, choosing bottom, trying to get that one-point escape and just thinking shots. You got to keep faith in your shots and keep shooting them and keep going. Don't be afraid to get tired.
You'll have 2 minutes to get those shots in. And McIntyre seems to be injured. Holding that left leg. And we will head to a commercial break here.
When a hospital invests in technology, skilled hands and keen eyes have new tools for diagnosing disease and making people better. At Scotland, we were the first in the region to provide 3D mammograms and robotic joint surgery, and the only hospital in the region to collaborate with Duke Health to offer both radiation and medical oncology for cancer patients. At Scotland, we invest in the newest technology for one simple reason: to deliver you closer care that's better by far.
Don't just throw a tailgate. Own the tailgate with a Bojangles Big Bow Box. Only Bojangles brings the flavor to every tailgate with mouth-watering chicken.
Jaquan McIntyre toughing it out here. He'll stay out there.
See, McIntyre, since he had an injury timeout, Corbett chooses what position he wants to be in. So he chose bottom as he got the one escape.
The importance of McIntyre getting back out there and wrestling, it would be an automatic 6 points with a medical forfeit. There's a reversal.
You got that two takedown right there. Score 6-3. Corbett has 39 seconds of ride time. The crowd seems fired up now, trying to get behind Jay.
1:26 remaining in the third. Jaquan McIntyre well within striking distance.
Caution on Corbett. Went before the whistle. That's his first caution. Jay does not want to waste any time and puts him in neutral. That gives Corbett 1 point, making it 7-3.
One 14 remains. Seven to three here in the third period.
It's becoming, helped him in his advantage, as you were saying before, being tall and lanky, keeping his legs away from McIntyre's shots, especially late in the third, being up. Hard to get on those shots, those legs.
Clock under 45 seconds. McIntyre looking to rally back against the top wrestler at 133 in the region.
Looks like both looking for duck unders here.
15 seconds.
Jay needs to throw a big move here to come out with the win. With the shot. Corbett scores two.
So a 6-point difference there, no major decision, so UNCP still in front, but Majid Corbett picks up the victory at 133 over Jaquan McIntyre. And I will see Jonathan Miller against Alex DeLeggy, and Jonathan Miller, the early portions of this season, has really proven to be one of the top wrestlers on UNCP.
Definitely, Jonathan Miller is a very athletic, smart wrestler, and I have faith in him being in the national finals.
Ranked 8 in the nation at 141.
His hips are crazy. It's going to be a fun match to watch.
Going up against Alex DeLeggy, a true freshman from Bayshore, New York.
Looks like Limestone's full of a lot of northern team, of northern wrestlers, a lot of New York and New Jersey.
Yeah, from our neck of the woods.
Yeah. Jonathan Miller on the shot. Scored his 2 takedown, trying to get his riding time in now.
He went 1-1 this past weekend. A 3-2 loss against number 3 ranked Darius Bunch of West Liberty.
Yeah, he wrestled really well. Definitely was a tough loss, but a lot of good things that came out of that match.
Yeah, bounce back, a Tech Fall victory against Mount Olive the next day.
Another takedown for Jonathan Miller, scores 4-1. Looks like Miller's just trying to rack up those points. He's very good on his feet. Lets the guy escape and takes him down again.
The MEC Wrestler of the Week back in early November. This is UNCP's first season in the Mountain East Conference, so getting to take on some different opponents.
Definitely,
especially as the season goes on.
Definitely a lot of northern opponents. We're used to wrestling down south and staying down south. We're going to be traveling a lot to Pennsylvania and Ohio this year.
Headed out to Colorado as well, right?
Colorado, Las Vegas.
Las Vegas.
Fun season this year, a lot of traveling.
Another takedown for Miller. 6-2 here, a minute 24 to go in the first period. Are there any differences that you foresee besides the travel and making the move into the MEC?
No, if we just wrestled best, I feel like we could we'll always come out on top. So traveling, that don't bother us. We enjoy traveling. We don't get out much.
John Gross alongside UNCP redshirt senior wrestler Joe Ballantyne.
Always a pleasure being up here.
Yeah, well, we're thankful to have you up here with us.
It's a nicer view, too. I like it.
First home dual meet of the season for UNCP. Hosted the Pembroke Classic a couple weeks ago. They went pretty well there, too.
Yeah, we had a lot of kids on the podium. Always a good way to start the season, know where we're at. Helps us build confidence to start the season. Lots of hand fighting. Jonathan Miller likes to hand fight. For his next shot, as he hits a dump. Gets no back points, but he's in a tilt as he loses that bar, that on, excuse me. As time runs out.
End of the first period, 5-point edge for Jonathan Miller of UNC Pembroke. And he'll head to the bottom here to start things off in the second. One of the best in the nation at 141. Miller ranked number 8th, going up against the true freshman in Alex DeLegge. And Miller finding plenty of success early on, and he starts it off with an escape.
Miller loves being on his feet. He loves to show off, but he does a good job of doing it.
If you can back it up, why not?
Definitely.
Braves lead 4-3 in team scores. They started off with Nick Daggett. A major decision, giving the Braves a bonus point. And Majeed Corbett, one for Limestone at 133.
Miller's trying to get their momentum back on Braves' side. As he puts his opponent to his back, his opponent tries to find cement mixer, but Miller, smart relic, keeps him on his back, and he gets the pin! Wow! Jonathan Miller, being a redshirt senior, being the smart wrestler, knows how to counter when the freshman makes a poorly mistake on that, trying to hit a flying cement mixer early in the match.
Yeah, had him on the near fall for a little bit, and then picks up the pin.
Put him away.
Able to put him away. 6 points for the Braves. Now lead 10-3 as we head to another bout that you touched on pre-game, pre-match, and at 149, it's Pentecost for the Braves.
Looks like he's wrestling Phil Ruse. Looks like Matt Ross won't, or Rose, excuse me, won't be getting this matchup today. 'Sammy Pentecost. You take a shot on him, it's very, very hard to score. We call him the King of Scrambles on our team.
Went 2-0 this past weekend, including a pin.
Oh, and he throws a headlock. Does he get the two? He gets the... Wow. Ref calls it off, says no two.
Braves fans not all too happy about that.
Not at all, but looks like Sammy's back on a double as he takes it down at the end of the match, and he does score the two that he deserves on the other side of the mat. The crowd is going nuts. Definitely did not agree with that call. Vice versa, I would not agree with that call, even if it was Limestone guy or not.
Was able to respond, though, and pick up the takedown. An early lead for Pentecost, 2:12 to go in the first period.
Pentecost is a tough, tough top wrestler. Ruse has a great job of getting a reversal two there. Ruse with the leg. Looks like he's trying to get a cradle. He has it locked up. Sammy might be in a little trouble here. As he reverses the cradle, no! Ruse does a great job of keeping his hips down. As they end up out of bounds.
A lot of action here in the first period.
I was about to say that. Only a minute and a half in. It felt like a whole match.
Well, this is where it gets fun. Some early action. Braves looking to keep things rolling in this top portion of tonight's dual meet.
Caution on Limestone. He's taking his time. Caution, another caution. That's two cautions, one more caution, and that'll be 1 point for Pentecost.
I'm not seeing Matt Rose wrestle. Rose, ranked 8th nationally at 149, was the Super Region 2 champion last year.
It's upset Rose is not coming out, though. I don't know why they don't have him out there. Must be hurt. But another Jersey guy, Phil Rose, comes in and takes the spot. Always got to be ready. Never know when someone's going to come in or someone's going to get hurt. Always got to be the next guy up. Which he's doing a good job keeping the score 2-2. Does he get the reversal? He gets the reversal with the Peterson. No back points. The crowd is cheering, trying to stay behind Sammy, getting him fired up.
Six-two lead for Pentecost over Ruiz. 4-2, pardon me.
Sammy doing a good job riding those legs in. Keeping his chest up and his hips down, putting a lot of pressure on his shoulder and his neck. Short time in the first. Big confident booster ending up on top after that first period.
Now I do have to ask you, as someone who hasn't wrestled myself, it looks so intense down there and you have a coach yelling at you, fans yelling at you to do things. How much of that are you able to take in and try to react upon, and how much of it do you kind of just block out?
Me personally, I block a lot of wrestlers block everything out. Okay. The only time they really hear something is when they choose to hear it. But hearing the crowd and having that energy go through your body, it helps you a lot. You hear a lot of yelling, but once you hear the crowd behind you, it gets you fired up.
Gets you going, helps push you to the finish line, I'm sure.
Of course. Stalling, man on bottom. He has two cautions and a stall call. One more of each is 1 point for Pentecost. Pentecost doing a great job of riding legs, keeping a lot of pressure on the bottom guy. It's very hard to escape and get out here.
Minute 10 to go in the second period.
Another stall on bottom guy. 1 point awarded to Sammy Pentecost. Pentecost is trying to work for a turn. Bottom man looks like he's just trying to survive.
Seconds to go here in the second period. Our fourth bout of the evening.
Looks like Pentecost is trying to get a guillotine here. Trying to take that hand and put it over his head. Flatten him back out. Another stall warning.
Another stall.
I believe one more and that could be the match.
Two penalty points off of stalling.
That's huge for Pentecost going into the third period. Pentecost chooses bottom.
What's the approach here if you're Pentecost?
Get out, take him down.
Get the sense that always seems to be the approach.
Of course, as many points as possible. Having him broken like that, you want to keep scoring points, keep breaking your opponent in the mind, in the mental state. Try to score as many points as possible as Sammy gets the reversal and scores 2. Up by 6. He has that riding time point locked in no matter what now. Actually, excuse me, not no matter what.
Minute 28, clock running, riding time over 2 minutes. But certainly looking favorable here.
Now yes, I locked in.
Up by five, so a takedown could give him bonus points because he'll have the riding time locked in.
And he does get the two. Sammy looks like he's in better shape as it's hard for the Limestone guy to escape. Pettergoss in another shot at the edge of the mat. Try to take him in before he steps out.
45 seconds.
Both legs went out.
Second close call of this bout. 45 seconds remain. Pettecost with the riding time locked in.
Rez mistake, took a shot. A lot of guys take a shot on kids to waste some time, but Sammy's very good at defending shots as he is on, and he gets the two here.
Yep. 25 seconds, Pettecost in line for bonus points.
Yes, riding time locked in with 15 seconds left in the mat.
Braves have already had one major decision tonight. It was Nick Daggett to open up the evening. Pettecost, 5 seconds from giving UNCP four more points. As the crowd comes to their feet, Sammy Pettecost, convincing at 149, gives the Braves 4 points. UNCP now leading 14-3. Really as strong of a start as you can get here in the early goings. How much confidence does that give you as a team when your early wrestlers are finding success?
Definitely a lot of confidence, especially earning a lot of wins off bonus points. We got two major decisions and a pin. So getting those bonus points early in the match gives a lot of comfort room to our upper weights, allow them to perform better and not be as nervous going out there.
157, another big time bout. Tyler McCosey, ranked number 11 of the nation. He's been doing this for a while here at UNCP at a very high level. An early takedown though for his opponent and Sean Glasgow, fourth in the region.
Yeah, McCosey definitely stalled Glasgow last year a couple of times. McCosey, one of the captains on the team. Very good wrestler, and I don't get worried when he gets taken down early like this. McCosey has a big-ass tank, and he has a lot of wins to come back from behind.
Trying to get out.
Cozy does not stop though. Does a great job of keep coming to his feet, earning him for the one for the escape.
2-1, Glasgow in front. 140 remaining in the first.
Glasgow back onto his legs. Cozy trying to hit a scramble, but gives up two. Smart move there, giving up the two instead of giving up back points, possibly. Glasgow got that ankle hook.
For one, Glasgow make that 4-2. Another escape for Tyler McCosey. Went 2-0 this past weekend against West Liberty and Mount Olive. West Liberty, yet another ranked opponent the Braves have faced in the early goings. And tonight, a 14-3 team score lead over the 17th ranked Limestone Saints.
McCosey had a great weekend the past weekend, wrestled really tough.
Just under 30 seconds to go here in the first. McCosey, Glasgow at 157.
Glasgow is a wrestling, has a lot of members in his family wrestled. I know his brother wrestles for Rutgers. He's a Rutgers guy. Two New Jersey natives.
Glasgow out of Newark, New Jersey. One of four wrestlers from Bound Brook High School on this Limestone Saints roster.
Cozy chooses bottom. Still in this match, even though he's down by two. He's in an optional start. Gets his one escape. Glasgow has a minute and 10 riding time. Back on the shot. Coach, you're doing a good job of trying to defend that. But gives up two. A lot of wrestlers would start giving up, but McCosey, he's a fighter. He don't give up. He keeps going. He's mentally strong here.
Only the second period. Still a minute 24 to go in this period.
Still in the match as he gets in the leg. Seems like that was the first time he actually got into a leg. He has to do a better job of setting up his shots. Glasgow is a great defensive wrestler.
Under a minute remaining in the second. Cozy looking to get some shots in. All four of his points have come off of escapes.
Taking multiple shots. Glasgow's doing a great job of keeping his legs back. Glasgow doing a great job of having a shot reshot. When McCosey takes a shot, blocks it, and is on to another shot. Great way to set up a shot.
15 seconds.
McCosey trying to hand fight and set up to a better angle as time runs out.
So McCosey very much still in this one. Trailing just by two.
McCosey goes to lift. It's a mat return. Tries another time. Has to hit him before he gets hit with stalling, but brings him out. Glasgow looks a little winded.
Cozy looking to take advantage. 13 seconds into this final period.
This is where McCosey peaks. In the third period when his opponents get tired, he just gets started. McCosey does erase Glasgow's riding time, where he only has 52 seconds now. But still a possibility. To gain.
Just over a minute remains.
Lasso snaps him down to the mat. Koji trying to get back into a leg.
Stop. 45 seconds. McCosey being cheered on by the home crowd here at Lumbee Guaranty Bank Court.
McCosey taking most of the shots here. Finally, Lasco gets hit with Stalin. It might be too late though.
25
McCosey
seconds.
On another shot. Crowd trying to be, really trying to get behind McCosey's. Gets hit with another Stalin. McCosey just needs a takedown to tie this match now.
10 seconds
left. McCosey on another shot. Great effort by McCosey.
That'll do it as Glasgow comes away with the win. And Joe, you said it during, I believe it was the first period, very skilled defensively, and we saw it on full display.
Yes, of course, yeah. Glasgow did a great job of keeping his legs back and waiting for McCosey to shoot and counter off of it.
So UNCP still an 8-point lead after the decision goes to Limestone, the victory for Glasgow, and we will take a quick break here from Lumbee Guaranty Bank Court, UNCP Limestone, a top 25 showdown, two of the top teams in the Southeast region. We'll be back in just a few. Don't go anywhere. This is UNCP Wrestling here on the UNCP Sports Network.
Could this get any more perfect?
Pimento cheese. Dude, get it with pimento cheese. Trust me.
Perfect just got perfecter. Introducing Bojangles Cajun Filet Biscuit with our new pimento cheese. Melty, cheddary.
The town of Pembroke, incorporated in 1895, is a proud community rich in heritage. Pembroke is a quaint but growing town regarded as the social, political, cultural, and commercial center for the Lumbee tribe, the largest American Indian tribe east of the Mississippi River with over 58,000 members. The town hosts a variety of events during the year, none larger than Lumbee Homecoming, which annually brings in over 30,000 visitors. We welcome you to visit our unique town and encourage you to read and learn more about Pembroke.
Choose to transform.
Choose to discover.
Choose value.
Choose to make a difference.
Choose to succeed.
Choose to be a brave.
When you choose UNC Pembroke, you choose small classes and personal attention. You choose quality and affordability because we are on NC Promise campus. Tuition is only $500 a semester in-state and $2,500 a semester out-of-state. Visit uncp.edu or call 910-521-6262 for more information.
A nurse at Scotland Health is
a healer, touching patients' lives at every turn.
An ally, working as a trusted teammate with the best doctors.
A blower of bubbles, part child whisperer, part kid at heart.
A winner, recognizing excellence through Daisy Awards.
And of course, a caring friend. Scotland Health nurses are many things to many people. But to us, they're simply better by far.
Back here at Lumbee Guarantee Bank Court, John Gross alongside UNCP redshirt senior wrestler Joe Ballantyne. Joe, thoughts on the first half of action?
Yeah, definitely huge, getting a lot of bonus points out of those matches. Nick Daggett getting a major, and Jonathan Miller getting the pin there, also with Sammy Pericos getting that major. So those bonus points are huge for us going into our heavier matchups.
All right, we'll bring things right back down to the action. We'll start it off at 165. Here as we continue this dual meet between UNCP and Limestone. It's Caleb Warner for UNCP, 7th ranked in the nation against Garrett Beam.
Garrett Beam, quick on a shot. Caleb Warner bumped up a lot of weight classes, wrestled 149 last year, wrestling 165 this year. Did a lot of bulking in the summertime.
Beam, a national qualifier last year. Should be a pretty good one.
Two national qualifiers. Caution already on Limestone. It's been a big mistake on Limestone this year, or this match, excuse me, hitting a lot of cautions. Beam with a nice mat return, trying to get a tilt. Caleb trying to stay in the mat.
You mentioned the cautions. We've seen Stallings. I mean, the penalty points in it have really almost exclusively gone in favor of UNCP.
Yeah. Those penalty points do add up. Gives the guys a lot of confidence, especially wrestling, knowing they have room to make mistakes where the opponent doesn't have room. As Limestone gets hit with another caution. One more caution, and Warner gets a point. So Beam might be a little bit more hesitant on the first move right off the whistle. Warner on a Granby roll out of bounds.
Warner spent 2 years at Campbell, a year at Central Missouri. Now here at UNC Pembroke. 7th nationally at 165.
Warner with the switch. Trying to get a stall call on his opponent, as he does. And you're on his legs for that long. The ref starts counting. After 5 seconds, he gets hit with the stall. Difficulty with the clock.
Let's see, it says 137 right now.
Gives the wrestlers a little break. And a caution. The third caution on Beam, giving Warner a point. Beam's going to be a little bit more hesitant making that first move, getting a little advantage to Warner.
Brave students really making some noise and letting Limestone hear it. This has been a common trend, as we've talked about throughout tonight. We're a level at two.
Beam looks a little angry with a nice collar tie right there. Warner gets the escape off an optional start. Scores now 2-2.
Minute 20, clock ticking.
Beam on a shot. Gets to two.
He'll bring it back.
Great job of running back to the center of the mat, as you mentioned. Running back to the center of the mat when your opponent's tired messes with their head.
Yeah, he seems to be locked and ready to go. Another escape within a point.
One takedown, Warner's back on top here. Great job of throwing those fakes in.
30 seconds of the clock.
Beam got Warner in a front head. Looks like he's getting choked out from my angle. Beam gets two. Looks like it's going to be a dogfight for the rest of these two periods.
A competitive first period.
Beam did a great job of getting those three takedowns, scoring 6 points. But he does look a little winded. A lot of wrestlers start off strong. Let's see how they finish, though.
And I'm guessing you can really see that in your opponent when they start to look tired.
Of course. It's a big confidence booster. Mash. Warner giving up a reversal, trying to throw those legs in.
Two reigning national qualifiers.
Warner doing a great job of getting to his feet, trying to fight those hands and keep those hips out as he gets the escape.
A minute 12 to go, second period.
Warner's still in this match, even though he's down by four. Still plenty of time.
Riding time in favor of Bean.
Warner in a shot. Bean did a great job getting a reshot in there. Looks like they're gonna get hit with stalemate at the edge of the mat.
He's gonna get the whistle. 42.3 seconds to go here in the second period. Started at neutral. Under 30 seconds. Garrett Beam the advantage.
Ref says there's action. Usually when someone gets shot out of balance, they get hit with stalling. But Warner was trying to circle back in into the mat.
5 seconds. We'll head to the third period. Warner still in this one, but It's been Garrett Beam who has really been the aggressor in this bout. Couple takedowns, saw a reversal. His Limestone bench fired up with him. Saints looking to get back into this. Trailing by 8 in team score.
I'm going to try and throw those legs back in. Very strong leg rider when he gets his opponent flat on the mat. Could not get him flat there. Gives up escape instead of giving up a reversal. Smart move by Caleb Warner. Beam back on the shot. Ref says action. At the clock, see how much time he has left in his third period. Beam is back on a shot. Looks like he's holding on, not trying to score, but just a waste of time.
Beam up 5, has the riding time. Takedown could move him closer to bonus points for his team.
Buzzer went off. Looks like there's a problem with the clock again.
Minute 24 to go, third period. We have yet to see Limestone secure bonus points tonight. All three of UNCP's victories tonight have resulted in bonus points. A couple major decisions and then the pin by Jonathan Miller. 15th straight year that UNCP and Limestone are duking it out.
So little words were said, little hands were hit. Warner on the front head trying to get the two, tries to close him by, he's in his shot. Does he secure two? He does get the takedown. Let's see if Warner has enough in his gas tank to pull something off in this last 35 seconds of the third period. He's down by 3.
Fans want a stalling call.
Warner has him flat on his hips. He's getting a little high. And he gives up a reversal right at the edge of the mat. Score would be 11-6 with the minute riding time, making him be up by 6, not giving him enough for bonus points.
6.2 seconds. Yeah, at this point, in the bet's about not giving up the bonus points.
Caution on red, yep. Giving Warner another point. One more caution, and that's the match.
That'll do it. 3 points for Limestone with the decision. The riding time, 12-8. As Beam is victorious, we continue to make our way through tonight's match.
Garrett Hill, new wrestler for the Braves, transferred here this year. Doing a great job of filling in the spot, 174. Had a great weekend this past weekend. I believe he went 2-0 this last weekend?
Yes, 2-0, including a tech fall against Mount Olive. He'll take on Hunter Haven.
Hill, originally from Texas. Living in North Carolina now. Guy's a real country boy.
Out of League City, Texas.
He'll try in a crackdown position trying to get two here.
It's Hunter Haven, his opponent.
Both sides getting rallied up, knowing this match is huge. And then one ball. 2 points for Hill.
Getting loud here in the Jones Center.
Ho's doing a good job of riding on top, putting a lot of pressure, bringing those wrists in.
Minute 50 to go in the first period. At 174, Garrett Hill versus Hunter Haven.
174, 184 matchups are going to be a huge decision of how this match is going to end up. Leading up to the 195, 197 and 285 on that.
The probable lineups that were submitted by Limestone said they were not submitting anyone for 184, but given how close this is, expect to see somebody compete.
Definitely, they'll throw someone out there.
They'll take on Brandon Sloop at 184. But a good one right here at 174.
Good Hill doing a great job of keeping that 1 foot in, letting that riding time build up, and getting a stall call on the bottom guy as they go out of bounds.
Hill with the chance to create some major separation for UNCP in terms of team score. They lead it 14-9.
Hill shows the ref that he wants to hit an optional start, giving his opponent the 1 point. Hill's confident that he's going to get another takedown. Trying to score more points before this period ends out. Hill is a very good hand fighter, likes to be in ties, very strong grip. Puts a lot of pressure on your head and neck, which causes you a little fatigue at the end of the match.
Still going there after the whistle. It looked like a late tug of the hair. A
little bit.
By Haven.
A little tug on the headgear. Let's see how Hill reacts to this. It's a little rivalry. It's a little things.
Well, you talked about in the open, this is becoming a rivalry. Two programs very familiar with each other. Guys who have battled throughout their collegiate careers as we end the first period. It's about as tight as it could possibly get. 2-1, Hill over Haven.
He'll choose his bottom. Trying to get that escape. Back on his feet quick. Trying to get his hips out. Trying to keep his riding time as he gets thrown out of bounds. Did a great job of getting to his feet. Needs to break that grip and get his hips out to secure that one. Back to his feet. Secures that one with a minute left in his riding time. Did a great job of getting it out in 3 seconds.
Minute and a half to go. Both sidelines fired up. Seen some chippiness in this bout. We saw Haven grab for the headgear. It's getting intense down there. Not to say it hasn't been intense all night.
Little things trying to break your opponent, trying to get them mad. A lot of people can't control their anger, so get them angry, make them make mistakes. Hopes you in your favor. Haven back in a shot. As Hill shoots him off out of bounds and gets a stone call out of it, giving him the one. A caution! The crowd is making Haven angry right now.
They're talking about those emotions on full display right now.
Score should be 4-1. That was his second stall call of the night. Hopefully they change that soon.
OT Johnson right now calling over to the scorer's table. It should be 4.
As he runs him out again, ref says action. Pembroke disagrees. Hill is so powerful and strong. He starts running those feet. It's hard to stop.
Heating of the minds right now at the scorer's table. It should be 4-1. We'll see if they add that point. At least both of us believe it should be 4-1. Scoreboard still says 3-1.
Pembroke does a great job of staying in shape and finishing matches.
30 seconds remaining, the second period of action.
As you can tell on the mat, Hill's gas tank looks like it's still filled to the top.
At 174, Hill versus Haven.
Well, that's a great job of hand fighting. Haven's trying to slide that by. Coach doing a great job of staying in a good stance. 5 seconds left in the mat, in the period, excuse me. Hill back in a shot, cannot get it. Time runs out.
Round of applause for the Braves faithful. Hill certainly giving it his all. Slight edge here as we head to the final period of action.
Haven chooses bottom. Trying to mat return him, run him out of bounds before he gets hit with the stall call. Lifts him up, brings him back to the mat. Keeping his feet in bounds, letting that ride time tally up.
Ride time now approaching a minute 20 it's at 119 as the whistle blows with 141 remaining. So not locked in, but he's getting there.
Does not look tired at all. Gives him one.
Minute and a half to go. This quite possibly the most competitive bout we've seen.
Hill shoots him out. Hits him with the stall again. That's another one for Garrett Hill. One more stall on Limestone, and that could be the end of the match. Giving Pembroke a 6-point tally on the team score. Hill's doing a great job of keep pushing and pushing and pushing. Shooting his guys out of bounds, giving him that one stall call.
Riding time locked in for Hill. Garrett Hill, 55 seconds away from giving UNCP a big victory.
Hill on another shot, takes him down, to his back, no back points, but secures the takedown. 42 seconds left. Coach OT telling him to put him up, trying to get more points. Let him up. Looks like he broke his opponent. Haven looks like he could still have some in him.
Up 3 with riding time locked in as well.
Haven in a shot. Doesn't look like he's trying to score. Looks like he's trying to waste time. Throws in a cradle. That slips right through. 15 seconds left.
Six, five, four.
Great win for Garrett Hill.
big win for Garrett Hill. And
another stall,
but just 1 point shy of bonus points.
That might be,
although
you never tallied that one stall. That might be 4 points, team points.
Let's
that's
see.
Their fourth. That would be their fourth stall. That's 6 points for the team.
Let's see.
That could have been it the last second.
And that's what the UNCP sideline vying for.
Wow.
Both head coaches head to the scorer's table.
They never tallied that one stall.
No.
They got hit with two stalls
right
in the first period. And then two at the third period.
Right, so that would be four in total.
I don't know if the ref waved off the first stall call or not. Let's see how that turns out.
Chatting right now at the scorer's table with Todd Anderson. We'll see what the final decision here is. What we do know, Garrett Hill comes away with the victory. It's win by decision.
So I guess they called off that stall warning in the beginning, in the first period.
Regardless, a big 3 points.
That would have been huge for the team, but still a huge big 3 points. As Sloop takes a shot right off the whistle. Tries to lift some. Sloop a national qualifier last year. Had a great season last year. Has been a little slow start this year. But he's a March wrestler. He does well in March.
They're ranked 11th nationally right now. Lost via major decision over the weekend. Uncharacteristic as he looks to bounce back. You mentioned he finishes season strong.
Scoop on another shot. On another shot. He gets two. No two yet. Prince has a great whizzer. Scoop trying to bring it back in. Trips him up as he gets the two. Great smart wrestling, edge wrestling on the edge of the mat. Bringing him in and securing that takedown.
Sloop going up against Hayden Prince, 174 listed. Wrestling right now at 184.
Looks like Prince is giving up a little bit of weight. Looks like he's much taller than Sloop. But size does not always matter in height in wrestling.
Prince, the native of Goose Creek, South Carolina.
Goose Creek.
It's a pretty cool name for a town.
That's a southern state. That's
yes.
A south town right there.
When we talked about Hill before from League City, Texas, that is quintessential Texas right there, League City.
Everything's bigger in Texas. Sloop doing a great job of riding on top. Is he Matt return? No, he lets him get the one.
We're at 184, so just two bouts remaining after this.
A shot. Two with the takedown. If the Braves come up, if Sloop comes up with bonus points in this match, it secures the match on this bout. Sloop wins a major decision or better. Actually, major decision, it could be a tie.
They could still tie, right? 21-21. But that would take a couple of falls.
When it ends with the tie, correct. If it ends with the tie, if first goes who has the most wins, and if they tie 5-5 with most wins, then it goes who has the most pins.
So far, we've seen just one pin. It was Jonathan Miller for UNCP. Prince ranked 5th nationally at 174, but again, up a weight class at 184 to take on Brandon Sloop.
Gives up the one, but he's back in a shot. Nice scramble right before time runs out.
Another close first period of action. Prince selecting to take bottom.
Sloop gets hit with a caution. Explaining. It's on set and then a whistle. Prince gets an escape right onto a shot. Sloop does a great job defending. Gets a knee pick. Back into 2 points. Trying to get a tilt as they go out of bounds.
Minute 27 remaining in the second period. John Gross alongside UNCP redshirt senior Joe Ballantyne. UNCP as a team, they've led throughout tonight. A strong start courtesy of two-time national qualifier, All-American wrestler Nick Daggett at 125.
Sloop on another shot, throws that arm by, and secures another 2 takedown. Sloop very good on his feet, knows how to score. Very athletic kid too. Was a great running back in high school. Very good at running people over, as you saw in that takedown right there.
Well, wrestling and football, two sports that occasionally go hand in hand.
Definitely. He tries an ODU with the claw. Didn't feel it. Gave up the one. Back in a double. Switches over to a single. Trying to pop that head out. Prince has nice long legs, keeping those hips down. Scooping an underhook. Great defensive wrestling by Prince.
24 and a half seconds to go in the second.
I missed what happened.
Looks like the official took a timeout.
I've never seen that. 8 seconds left in this period. Sloop trying to get on top. Finish on top. They finish on their feet.
Pretty high scoring affair through two periods. It's 8-6. Sloop in front for UNC Pembroke. Looking to bring his brave side just a little bit closer to a hard-earned victory over the 17th-ranked Limestone Saints. But still, really either wrestler can capture this bout.
caution on Limestone. Prince a little high. Sloop gets the escape. Keeps his riding time. Secures his riding time. Crowd is going nuts right now. You notice whenever the crowd was going nuts.
Yep.
Sloop felt it in his bones and took that shot.
And OT seemed to know it too. He came over to the crowd, told everyone get up, waved his arms, and the crowd responded, as did Sloop.
He knows these bonus points are be huge at the end of the match. Trying to get in another shot. Crowd's yelling, stalling. Sloop looks like he's taking most of the shots.
Minute 14 to go. Riding time secured for Sloop. Now it's just about securing some bonus points as well.
Prince in the shot. Sloop trying to get his two. Front head. Taking a second break. That might be bad. Calling a stalemate right here.
50 seconds.
He can score two. Prince brings that leg back in. Does a great job bringing that leg in. Does he secure the two? He does. 40 seconds left. Score 11-9. Looks like Sloop is going to secure that riding time though. This match looks like it's going to be a little tighter than we thought.
Just looking to hang on now. Sloop underneath. 24 seconds. And we'll get a reset. Riding time secured. 2-point edge in the scoreboard.
In. There's 10 seconds. Prince looks like a strong leg rider. Sloop looks like he's just trying to hold on here.
5 seconds. 2-1, and a crucial victory for Brandon Sloop at 184 wrestling Hayden Prince, wrestling up a weight class. And that brings the Braves oh so much closer to a big-time win over 17th-ranked Limestone. Steve, regular decision there. 3 points to the team score for UNCP. They now lead 20-9 with 2 bouts to go.
Matt Rudy, number 5-ranked in the country. Looking to get as many bonus points as possible. Limestone comes out with 2 pins, matches over, with them winning by 1 point.
It's Marcus Montgomery for UNC Pembroke.
Marcus Montgomery, very good wrestler coming out of South Carolina.
You mentioned Rudy, 5th nationally. He won the Wolfpack Open up at NC State earlier this season, beat 4 Division I wrestlers en route to that victory. Redshirted last year, but he's been dominant in the early stages this season.
Definitely. Marcus doing a great job of holding his own. Hand fighting really well, trying to get a shot in. Creating that angle. Marcus in a single. Rudy does a great job of keeping his legs back. Back to their feet. Say Montgomery doesn't care if he's ranked or not. He's going to wrestle him his way.
I figure that has to be the mindset, right?
Always got to. Rankings don't mean anything. Anything could happen on any given day.
Do you go into it knowing that you're slated to wrestle a ranked opponent?
You go into it knowing it's going to be a dogfight. You should go into every match knowing it's going to be a dogfight. You just got to give your all.
So same mindset, night in, night out. But midway through this first period, Montgomery standing strong against fifth-ranked Matt Rudy.
Rudy looks like he gets the first takedown. Rudy looks like he's trying to set up to a bow and arrow, trying to hook that back ankle. Marcus doing a great job of building his base, trying to come back to his feet. Needs a knee slide that leg out.
45 seconds.
The size of Rudy is incredible. It does look like a mismatch, even though they're at the same weight class. Marcus did a great job of coming back to his feet, getting that one. Rudy snaps him down in the front head, spinning behind to secure that two.
Clock taken away here in the first period. Rudy controlling the riding time, just under a minute with 5 seconds on the clock here in the first period. And that's the position that will end the first period in. 4-1. Rudy in front, a couple of takedowns.
Limestone's bench knows that Rudy needs a pin. Here, trying to cheer him on.
One more bout after this. Right now we're 197. It's heavyweight on deck. We expect to see Marcus Bell versus Jervy Sistrunk.
Marcus trying to hit a Peterson, but he keeps that leg. Comes up to his feet. Gets one. Back in a shot, gets to two. Rudy hooks that back ankle. Trying to get a tilt. No points yet.
Nearly has him on the shoulder.
Nothing yet. Throws a half in. Marcus does a great job of clamping that down, trying to get back to his feet, gets pushed, flattened back out.
50 seconds to go in the second period.
Rudy running a Blair ride, putting that arm, that hammer lock on his back. Marcus trying to survive, trying to fight that arm down.
Limestone bench wants stalling. Not getting it.
Marcus does a great job of staying on his stomach. Gets hit with stalling, but did a great job of fighting off his back, not giving any back points there. 15 seconds left in this period. Marcus trying to fight his way back to his base.
Rudy already locking in riding time. 2:45. With 2 seconds to go here in the second period.
Marcus hit with a stall call in that second period. His first stall call. Looks like Rudy locked in the riding time. Almost 12 seconds. And he'll lock in that riding time. Marcus doing a great job of holding his own against this great wrestler.
Rudy knows he needs bonus points. A fall would be huge. Really the only way to keep his Limestone team still in this one.
Marcus got 2 more minutes to fight. And help Pembroke to a win, even though if he loses his match. Rudy trying to get that hammer lock again. Marcus got hit with another stall call. giving Rudy 1 point. Marcus trying to come up to his feet. He's up to his feet. Score is 7-3. Already has two stolen goals. Marcus is in the shot. Trying to hold on by fingertips. He has one arm on it. Rudy gets the two. A minute left in this match.
9-3, Rudy. And he's also secured riding time.
Coach OT yelling to Montgomery, stand up, keep fighting, keep fighting.
50 seconds. Seconds to go here in the third period.
Rudy trying to cross face, trying to get a cradle here, brings that arm in. The crowd is cheering Marcus on for these last 20 seconds. Marcus trying to come up to his feet. Rudy trying to secure a pin here. Trying to look for a cradle, looks like a near side cradle, has his head in the hole. Nothing yet.
10 seconds, just needs to stay off his back.
Marcus trying to build to his base. 3 seconds left. Got hit with one more stall. And that's the match. Even though gives enough bonus points.
Major decision goes in favor of Limestone and Rudy. But it's not enough. UNCP will hold on regardless of what happens here in the heavyweight bout. And take down Limestone. This grueling schedule in the early portion of this season has continued tonight, taking out the 17th ranked team.
Pembroke gave the forfeit, leaving the Braves with a 20-19 win over Limestone.
No reason necessarily to go after it at that point. You have it locked up.
What a great win for the Braves tonight.
20-19 the final. UNC Pembroke victorious. They move to 2-3 in the season in dual meets. First loss of the year for Limestone. They are now 1-1, and this is a top 25 battle. How big of a victory is this for your team?
Huge victory, especially over a rival team like this and a ranked team, a higher rank than us. Great confidence booster. Great job by Marcus Montgomery to fight for that match. Even though he lost that match, a great confidence booster against a ranked number 5 guy in the nation coming out to a major decision like that. Just a lot of good things looking for this team in the future, in the season. So a great way to end the week and start into a Thanksgiving break.
Yeah, finally back at home for the Braves, but now plenty of road matches.
Oh,
you're traveling.
Traveling a lot.
Yes, traversing the continental United States
that point. We're going to be seeing the West Coast, the Midwest. A lot of, I think we go to Colorado, Kansas, Vegas. You'll see me on the penny slots in Las Vegas.
Desert Duels, that's Vegas.
Yeah, that's
going to
be a lot of fun.
Western Colorado, that's in January. Taking on that weekend, team from New Mexico, a couple teams from Colorado.
It's going to give us a lot of opportunity to see the guys, different competition around the country, not just down south. So leading up to in March into nationals gives us a better understanding of who we're wrestling, what styles we're looking into.
Then finally returning back home in February 11th against Greensboro and Spartanburg Methodist. So UNCP, a top 25 victory over Limestone. Joe, thanks so much for joining us today. Best of luck throughout the season.
I appreciate it.
And it's been an absolute pleasure. You're a natural, my friend. You're a natural.
Thank you so much. Go Braves.
For our broadcast producer tonight, Dave Nguyen. Izzy Vasquez on the camera, my broadcast partner to my right, Joe Ballantyne. You can catch him on the mats all season long for the Braves. I'm John Gross. This has been Braves Wrestling on the UNCP Sports Network. Thank you so much for joining us, and have a phenomenal Thanksgiving week.